I want to talk to Dave and Keith a little bit about some statements that are being made about President Trump based on a tweet where he quoted somebody who made a statement about him. And some are saying that Trump is actually calling himself the King of Israel, the second coming of God. And it all started with this article by Allyn Root, or a tweet or statement by Allyn Root, and then was, you know, President Trump saw it, retweeted it. Dave, could you just talk to us briefly about what Allyn Root's article was and kind of explain the situation in a nutshell, as many of our listeners have probably paid attention to that, and there may be many others that haven't really understood what's going on with this kerfuffle.
Well, Issac, let me say it's a delight to be on board with you, and you interrogate us all you feel necessary to do, and we'll be glad to try to answer. The article, of course, by Wayne Allyn Root, he's Jewish by birth. He professes to be an evangelical Christian, and he was commenting basically in response to President Trump's attempt to defend his statement that he made that Jews are being disloyal if they vote for Democrats, when you've got Ilhan Omar and Rashida Tlaib, these two Muslim women who were rabidly anti-Israel, that are pretty much now the face of the Democratic Party. And so the president was saying, how can you vote for a party that elevates these two women to a high stature in their party and basically endorses, or at least up to this point has endorsed, their anti-Israel comments? So in response to that, Wayne Allyn Root said the Jews love the president. They consider him like, and that's an operative word, like the King of Israel, and like he's the second coming of God. And then President Trump yesterday just retweeted Wayne Allyn Root's comments. And Trump began his tweet with this: thank you, Wayne Allyn Root, for the very nice words. And then he ends his comments and just quotes or just copies Root's comments about him. Now, what a lot of people are saying, and they're saying that the president claimed to be God, he's claiming to be the King of Israel. That is not what he was claiming. He's not claiming to be either. He just retweeted Wayne Allyn Root's comments. Now, what I do wish is the president had included a disclaimer and said, you know, I'm not God. I'm not the second coming of God. You know, I appreciate the nice comments from Wayne Allyn Root, but that is not something that describes me. He chose not to do that for whatever reason. But the fact of the matter is, some of this, I think, is being blown out of proportion, and he's being accused of something that he did not do and something certainly that he did not say. Some people are using Issac Acts 12, where Herod stood up and gave a speech to people, and they said, this is the voice of God, not a man. The Bible says God struck Herod with worms, and he died on the spot. And they're using that as an analogy, saying something akin is going to happen to Trump. Well, I think there are some distinct differences between what Herod did and Trump just retweeting words by a supporter of his. Number one, Herod was persecuting the church at that time. He had already killed James. He had incarcerated Peter, was planning to kill him. Of course, we know Peter was ultimately released from jail. Trump is the antithesis of persecuting the Church of Jesus Christ right now. He's one of the greatest advocates for religious liberty in the evangelical church. So there's some very distinct nuances that need to be factored in when people want to draw that analogy. So again, I want to say this. I wish the president had said maybe a little more. He did not. But he was certainly not claiming to be the second coming of God. He was not claiming to be the King of Israel. He was just thanking Wayne Allyn Root for some nice comments.
Keith, you and Dave both worked with folks there on Capitol Hill in D.C., and you've seen different politicians and political things. As a pastor who's worked with politicians, your take on this, what do you see in the context of what is going on with Trump's response there?
Well, I agree with everything that Dave had just said. A lot of people are taking Trump, as making some kind of theological statement. I don't believe Trump had any theological intent with that. He didn't intend anything eschatological about it. Those are eschatological terms that were used there. One writer that I read the article correctly identified those as coming out of the dispensational scheme of theology, system of theology. I think Trump was just intending to highlight his support of Israel. And he has, of all of our presidents, probably more than any, very faithfully supported Israel, to the great consternation, of course, of the left politically, and the great consternation of the Arab world. Israel is surrounded by nations that deny pretty much its right to even exist. And so Trump was just trumpeting that, I believe, was where he was coming from, like I said, without any intent to be attaching any theological significance to the terms that were involved.